Hello and welcome to Red Stapler channel. In this tutorial, we are going to show you how to create an animated film grain effect with Pure CSS in just a few minutes. Ready? Let's check it out. The concept of this tutorial is to create grain noise texture and then apply it to our page and then use CSS transform to animate it. First, let's start with creating the texture using Photoshop. Create a new image with 100 pixels width and height. And then create a noise using Add Noise Filter. Increase the grain amount as you like, but don't forget to select monochromatic. Now we need to remove the white background to create transparent texture. First, let's invert the image color. Then we are going to open a color channel window and select any channel. Then click Load Channel as a selection at the bottom. This will select all the grain noise. Since each grain is so small, you won't be able to see the selection highlight. Then create a new fill layer from the selection with black color. Now we have the grain noise layer. Let's delete the original white background. And finally, save it as transparent PNG. Now this is optional. I'm going to convert the texture into Base 64 in order to embed it into the CSS. There are lots of online tools for this. Just upload the image and you will get the encoded text. Let's keep it for now. Let's work on HTML. First, create a background div. Then in CSS, set the position to absolute and 100% viewport width and height. Then set overflow hidden to disable the scroll bar. I'm also going to create a yellow gradient background to create an old looking. Now I'm going to create a pseudo element and use our grain texture as background. After setting the position and size, use the base 64 encoded text as data URL. Now I'm going to animate the noise layer to create a film grain effect. It's pretty simple. Just use CSS transform and translate the element position. I'm going to create 6 keyframes and translate it randomly. Now in adding animation, I'm going to use steps to remove the tween between the keyframes. Now because of the layer is moving, you will see the edge of the noise layer. We can fix this by increase the size and change its starting position. Now, if you want to apply the firm grain to other elements like div or images, you can do it easily by setting the z-index to -1. And that's all for this video. If you enjoyed this tutorial and want to see more, subscribe our channel to stay tuned for weekly update. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.